Hello and good day. Today we'll be showing you the installation of our heat exchanger. We have a 65 liter tank, which up till today did not have a heating system. And RoverLand gave us a helping hand in getting this set up. So we'll show you how this is done right now. All right, so here we've got the car fully installed. Here we have the lid, and from the lid, if I turn this on, what happens is that we'll see the temperature of the water. So right now it's 14 degrees. Down here, this is just a switch. Turn on the valve, which will let the coolant pass through the whole, all the cables, which again are beneath, and it comes through here. So you've got the water coming in, the coolant's coming in from here, going through that metal hose, which is inside, back out here, back into the engine coolant. And as you've seen, the welder has properly cleaned this out, so there's no leaks. This part right here is very dry. And this pipe that you see here is actually a pipe that goes into the water tank. So what you see, and this is actually just the airflow so that the water can exhale, I mean, come out properly at the right pressure. So these are different tools we're going to be using to install the heat exchanger in the car. So these are aluminum rods that are gonna fit into the water tank, which we will then connect with these pipes to go from the engine coolants into the water tank. Now, what this is this is what actually these connections are gonna come in here. So this is gonna be inside the water tank. This whole metal cabling will be inside the water tank, and we'll have this sticking out of the metal tank. So just imagine that the water tank is on the left of my finger. So all here, you have the water tank with these cables inside, and you'll have this part coming out of the water tank. Now this part will have then a connection with this cable all the way to the front of the engine where the coolants are. And the idea is that when the engine is running and warm, the coolants are going to transfer all around the engine, but also through the black pipe and through this. And now when it reaches the other side, so inside of the water tank, you'll have this cable which is inside the water tank. And the idea is that because it's metal and it's going to heat up very hard, it's going to also heat up the water. And so that's an idea. So it's a very ingenious method. You don't need any electrical power or wiring. All you have to do is just make sure your engine is warm. So it's sort of a free water heating system when your engine is warm. So that's what we're going to be doing today. And we're doing this from RoverLand's garage. And if you see here, we have the two defenders.
Yeah, in Belgium.
It's his defender. And he's got a TD5, it looks like, or a TDI. And this is our defender. So what I was saying was that here you've got the water coolants coming from the engine. And what we're going to do is cut here, make an insertion. Make the cable, the black cable I showed you, go below the car, below the chassis. So what it's gonna do is gonna run along this part, come back from behind the chassis, so back there, and this will be here. Of course, it'll be much clearer later, but then when everything is installed, but here we'll have the cables coming in. And from here, we're gonna make two insertions. Here you see them, two gaskets, two insertions here, and put that long cable inside. And then we have a welder who's gonna close that back up, and we'll test it out. There you go. So that will be a hot shower system for us. It is going to change everything.
The first step of the process is just to check out where we're going to be cutting and having the cables come in from the engine. So this is the best place for my water tank anyways, seeing that it is at seat level of the back seat. So here what we've done is a few holes, the cables will be coming through here. We've tightened the cables below the car on the chassis, made it come back to the front and intersected it where the coolants are. So one cable would continue its normal course throughout the engine, and the other one would go under the chassis and into my water tank. Meantime, here we are cabling up an LCD screen which will show the temperature of the water tank directly from passenger and the driver's seat.
From the switch, we will first power the 12 volts for the LCD, so for the screen. Mm-hmm. And then we have the grounding. But then from the 12 volt, we'll also make a connection to the valve in the front. And that's okay. The cable we have pulled, so that's one cable. And then the other side of the valve will be connected to the ground of the vehicle, which we'll do in the front. And then the black cable, which we haven't used yet, will be the ground for the LCD screen, okay, which will go directly there.
Here what you see, we're connecting the tubes from the coolants going down to the engine and back to the car. We're just making sure everything is nicely cleaned and tightened with cables, everything below, that we're just double checking everything is going to hold. And here we've made the two holes. So these were the two cables I was talking to you about earlier that are going inside the water tank, which will be what will heat the water tank because of the steel. It will heat the water tank as the coolants are passing through those cables. And voila, job is done. You can contact RoverLand directly or get in touch with us if you want more information, and we'll be more than happy to help you out. All the best, have a good day.